lighting might not be that good, guys, but we're going to do a compression test after the ride today. And it was a crazy ride. Went on reserve in front of a police station. And I broke my cool and swore on tape, but it was okay. Only two of them wanted to look at the bike and see how cool it was. But so anyways, we're going to screw in the compression tester. And I got this one used from a shop, so it's a good German one, I think. It should be trustable. So we'll put that there. Now we're going to kick it open with the throttle open so that we have maximum amount of air coming into the combustion chamber to compress. And that's something I read, I think, at B50.org. Ed was saying that or something. So first kick, we're going to not use a decompressor lever, hopefully, so it might slip. But here we go. We'll go again. And we get 145 or so. And our final kick was at 155 pounds per square inch. Now, you might see the needle dropping on your compression tester slightly. That's not leak down from your cylinder, that's leak down from the actual valve that holds the air in. So you push the release. We'll go for another few kicks. Now, without the throttle open, it goes only to about 60 first kick. The clutch slips. Clutch slips again. And we're up to 100. So we're going to try that with the throttle open now. So we're letting in all the air. And we'll go with the decompressor maybe. And my timing's okay. We get 95. And 150, 155, 160, 165. I'm not sure if this is really accurate, but 165 we get on our final kick there. We had about four or five kicks. We'll do one kick and see what we get. If we can get the clutch not to slip. 120, 140, 155, so 155 and 120 on our first kick, and that's my rebuild to the head that I did, and 1.5 millimeters off of the cylinder head so that it's dropped down a bit more. The compression ratio, I guess, is a bit higher, but I didn't think 1.5 millimeters was a lot. So, that's the compression test.